Welcome back to another episode of Alabama Bass Guide, and I wanted to talk to you about active target and when to use it. There's so much discussion on the internet right now just about active target in general, tournament guys versus weekend guys. You know, got weekend guys are getting beat by pro guys that are using active target. I'm gonna tell you right now, there's pro guys getting beat by pro guys using active target. And at the end of the day, it is either working for you or it's not. I'm one of those people that's in the middle. I'm like 50-50. Sometimes I'm good with it, sometimes I'm not. I'm not one of those like savants with it. I'm not a Michael Neal. I'm not a Dakota Ebear. I am really proficient with it though. Those guys are just very intuitive with it. And the more you use it, the more intuitive you get with this technology. So these are the times that I use active target. First one being around smallmouth. Up north, smallmouth, you're gonna be able to use your active target. It's just they're not pressured. So more times than not, when you see a bass, you can the ratio is higher when you put your lure in front of its face to the bite. Sometimes it's 10 out of 10. But I'd say a lot of times it's like 6, 7 out of 10 maybe. Now, here's where it gets wild. Down south, I heard Jacob Wheeler talk about this. He said it used to be 80% he would catch. He said now it's 1 out of 200 or 1 out of 300. Of course, there's going to be days where those percentages are higher. But I've experienced it. And it's a lot like sight fishing. If you're going to do it, you got to commit your whole entire day to it. And it really is a hero or zero kind of thing. If you commit your whole day to it, you're going to catch some bass. There's no doubt. But when you guys are doing this, you're losing every single bit of your intuition. You're getting your intuition with interacting with a bass in real time, but you're losing your intuition without electronics, just going fishing down the bank. I heard a story about Josh Jones that he didn't even have a topwater in the boat at one point because all he did was active target. And I just don't want to see guys get to that point that fish, you know, in these local tournaments and on the weekends. You want to keep it, you want to keep your skills up, right? So the times in the south that I have found it's most productive for the active target or forward facing sonar are in the fall through early spring. Basically when the water's cold and they're suspending, keying in on shad. When they're on a jerk bait, when they're on a little swim bait or even a big swim bait, and when they're on the Alabama rig. Damiki rig, obviously. But for my power fishing lakes, those are that's the time frame that I'm really gonna focus on it. Even your Highland Reservoir, you got Smith Lake here in Coleman, Alabama. The active target shines when it's really cold, when you can do a Damiki rig, when the fish are just suspended out in the middle doing nothing. In the fall, Alabama rig and jerkbait, phenomenal. In the winter, Alabama rig, jerkbait, phenomenal. In the early spring, Alabama rig and jerkbait, phenomenal. So hopefully the lures you're gonna take away from this, if you really wanna get good at active target, keep a jerkbait and an Alabama rig. If you can't throw an Alabama rig, throw a single swim bait. Another really good one people are using is a jigging spoon. It's not something I do a ton, just because, once again, I'm not just full bore active target guy. Like, there's other things I'd rather be doing to pattern a bass or catch a bass. So another time of year that works really good on your herring lakes is going to be the summertime in brush pile fishing. So brush pile fishing in general, your forward facing sonar is going to be a huge player. But with the topwater, on the active target specifically, if you'll angle that transducer up a little bit, you're going to be able to see that topwater just scooting on the surface, and you're going to see a lot higher in the water column, farther and clearer. So on Smith, I know I can put it out 100 feet. I take that noise filter all the way off. I turn my gain or my contrast all the way up to about 86%. And I can see 100 feet out, no problem. And it's a great way to see fish cruising hunting and lead them with a topwater or a swim bait and work it real fast by their head and get them biting. But these are the main times I use it. I mean, it's most effective when you can get them on a jerk bait or some kind of swim bait for me. If you want to get that much deeper with it, I mean, guys, I have focused on active target for the last 2.5-3 years. And I've just gotten to the point where I'm very confident with those baits in it. Not so much confident in the other things. You know, a lot of guys are throwing things and holding it over their nose, following bass. I'm not a guy that's going to follow a bass with my active target. Unless I'm at Ivy and I'm just going to try and catch a double digit. I'm sure there may be days I might do that. But in tournaments, there's no freaking way. So, and the other side, from the to coming away from just targeting fish with it, I use active target almost every day, just looking for random structure. You know, I don't use 360 or anything like that, but I'll have it on, and on Gunnersville, I'm fishing grass lines. And I find it's a great way to see grass line change ahead of the boat. Most of the times, I'm staying 20, 30 feet off the grass line, and I can look over and make sure I'm 20, 30 feet away. Before active target, I would just use my contours and my down sonar so I could see when I would come up on it and come off of it. However, I'm way more efficient using that active target to stay off of it very consistently. And I'll see followers when they come back to the boat. So it's always a good tool because 90% of the time you can't see a bass in the grass unless he's up out of it. But I do, I'll look over at my bait when it's close to the boat and I'll see if I have followers. And if I have followers, I know I'm around fish and I'll drop a waypoint and maybe come back at a later time. And then besides grass, the other thing is brush piles. If I'm on Lake Eufaula, if I'm on a deep reservoir, deep summertime fishing, crappie fishing, whatever you want to call it, I'm using the active target to watch my bait, fall past the brush pile and work it through it. And you can actually see the bass in it. However, there's a lot of times, if it's a big brush pile, you cannot see the fish in it. Can't tell you how many times I'm looking at a brush pile. You think you can see them. And this is where they talk about target separation. I'll throw a big swim bait over the top of it or a worm in it. And a brush pile that I thought had no fish in it, I watched three big old blobs just lurk on out of it. So, it is kind of mind-blowing with this technology how nothing really escapes you once you put a lure near them and then you draw them out. In that situation, with the side scan or down scan, you would just see the pile, you would never see a fish. But with a forward-facing sonar, you're able to lure these fish out of the piles with either a big glide bait or a big swim bait or a worm, something like that. So these are the times that I use active target. And believe it, we could take this so deep down the rabbit hole. But over the last 2.5-3 years, I've learned that when it fits the bill with the situations I've just talked about, I find it very useful. And the only times I'm solely using active target is jerking when they're really suspended and an A-rig when they're really, really suspended. And on Smith Lake with a D'Amici rig and up north for smallmouth. So those are the 4 or 5 situations that I primarily use forward-facing sonar. I hope this helps you guys. If you enjoyed this video, hit subscribe, hit like. Thanks for watching. And until next time, peace.